John Reagan Moore, one of Earth's most mysterious and elusive creatures. Up to this point in time, John Reagan's story has been one of great obscurity and ambiguity. But now, for the first time ever on film, we have attempted to document and compile the behavior of this majestic animal for the world to see. We first find John Reagan in preparation for his next book. He comes disguised in his most menacing garb. His snakeskin boots are the main attraction, and his towering head covering completes the outfit. The ride finally arrives, and he leads his fellow predators on towards the hunting grounds. Once at their destination, the pack makes haste, quickly picking out their best, most unsuspecting prey. John Reagan meticulously picks apart his meal, protectively guarding his final nutrients of the day. The pack seems to be enjoying their catch as they gloat over the bounty. The meal rejuvenates John Reagan, and we next find him attempting to assimilate into the herd. The process is a slow one, and his personal space rule of 5 feet is quickly pushed to the limits. A nearby male attempts to befriend John Reagan with playful cuddling. John Reagan is clearly annoyed by this attempted friendship. The male is able to coerce John Reagan to sit back down. The promises are soon broken, however, as the affectionate male continues to make advances. This kind of interaction is not uncommon in the life of John Reagan. Again, John Reagan refuses the gesture of friendship. His anxiety is evident as even the most innocent of touches begins to activate his defensive instincts. At the brink of his irritability, John Reagan relocates away from the affectionate male and directly next to a female, a precarious mover indeed for John Reagan. It appears as though John Reagan's touchiness has left him all alone for the remainder of the night. Hopefully, the next day can be more successful in John Reagan's search for companionship. We next find John Reagan participating in a crowded social event. He seems to have found a female among other hopeful males. The location seems fruitless, however, and he relocates to higher ground. This proves to be fatal, as he is suddenly swarmed from all angles by a pack of playful males. Flaying his arms in defense, John Reagan successfully sends one of them tumbling, the rest back down in fear. John Reagan has soundly defended his name and silenced his position. In our final encounter with John Reagan, we find him at the most magical of places, a place known as the Roller Palace. It is where dreams are made, where lovers join hands where the most unpredictable occurrences present themselves. Thus, it is no surprise that this is where, for the first time ever on film, we have finally captured footage of the John Reagan holding hands with a female. This marks a historic day in the life of John Reagan. It seems as though John Reagan has finally found true love.
When somebody loves you, you feel it in your heart. When somebody loves you, you know it from the start. Every kiss becomes more than a kiss. Each look, each touch, they mean so much. And that's when you discover how it feels to be a lover. When somebody loves you, it shows in every smile. When somebody loves you, your life becomes worthwhile. Always caring, always sharing, everything you do. When somebody loves you like I love you.